show you how to create the simplest budget ever. Set it and forget it. You can literally review this budget once a year and just quickly look at your account balances monthly. The best thing about it though, is if you decide once you start getting your finances in order that you want to look at it more closely or more often, you can. So let's jump right in. Hey everyone, this is Lauren Mack with Hacking the Rat Race, and I would love for you to hit the like button and subscribe so you don't miss any more videos on money, saving, and investing. Like I said, today I'm gonna show you how to create the simplest budget ever. Super easy, set it and forget it. If you stay till the end, I'm gonna share with you a way to make it super automated so you don't even have to think about it. So let's jump right in. The great thing about the strategy that I'm about to show you is it can be as hands-on or as hands-off as you want. This works so well because you'll see it sort of mimics the way people are looking at their money now, but in a more positive light. So the first thing to do is to open four separate bank accounts. At least three should be checking accounts, and the final one should be a high interest savings account. The next thing you'll want to do is pull the past 3 months of all of your bank statements and or credit card statements, basically any place that you're spending or receiving money each month. The reason I recommend 3 months is because it eliminates the chance of overlooking things or the possibility of irregular spending. Then you're gonna go through each month worth of statements and you're going to assign categories to each transaction. This could be money coming in, like your paycheck, side hustle money, etc. And each transaction going out, like rent or mortgage or bills, dining out. In the show notes below, there is a link where you can get a cheat sheet that will have all of this broken down with categories. Trust me, this part is the part that takes the most amount of work. Once you have this done, the rest will be easy. This is also great to do because I don't know how many times I've helped people and they are shocked at the amount they're spending in certain categories, and it really helps put things into perspective, especially on items or areas they don't really care about. One last thing to add is don't not do this process because you're afraid to look at your finances. They are what they are. Regardless if you look at them, it's best if you take control of them, regardless what they look like or how you feel about them. I promise it will 100% pay off to start doing this. Each step forward, no matter how small it is a step toward your big goal. Once you have them categorized, then you're gonna wanna total up each category. Most likely things like rent or mortgage will be quick, but say for dining out or gas for your car, total those up so you have the total amount you spent and each category for each month. Once that's complete, you're going to go to the next step, which is looking at what belongs in each of the four bank accounts. But let's go through each account so you know where things go. The first checking account is going to be your account that has all of your bills that are approximately the same each month. This would include things like your mortgage, rent, any stable bills like your cell phone bill that rarely change or only change slightly. This could include your utility bills or different types of insurance you pay monthly, credit cards, car payments, student loans, regular giving or tithing amounts, etc. You get the idea. Basically, all the bills and regular monthly expenses that are more or less the same amount and that you pay monthly. In this account, I would say try and have a 10 to 20% buffer. So if your bills in this account total $1,000 for an easy number, then you would need to have between $100 and $200 buffer in the account. That way the money is in the account for the bills that change slightly so it won't get overdrawn. If your standard monthly bills fluctuate drastically, you might want to have a little more of a buffer. For this account, literally each month, I would just take a few minutes to check what is hit to make sure your bills all seem within range and that the buffer is still good. Additionally, if you know a bill is increasing, then you want to account for that and increase the amount you're putting in this account monthly. The second account will be all of your bills that are not paid monthly or are things that need to be budgeted for, but you may not always need on a regular basis. For example, could be, say, car insurance that you pay twice a year versus each month. This could also include things like car repairs, oil changes, medical visits, etc. So, either things you pay irregularly or things you will most likely need but are not consistent. For these items, you will take how much you've spent in the last 3 months or even look back, say, over the last year to get an idea how much you've spent on car repairs or doctor visits. In this account, you will need to have a monthly amount to account for these items, and they will just sit in this account. Again, monthly, you just need to glance at this account and make sure it is not getting too low. However, you only want to use this money for items you have budgeted for. Sometimes people will check in on this account and see money accumulating and think they can use some of it. Don't do that. We'll talk about that a little bit later. Money should not be used from this account except to pay for the bills that are assigned to it, no matter how much money is growing in it. Before we get to the third account, I'm going to recommend getting all of your bills on autopay if they are not already. So literally, you don't even have to think about it. If you absolutely hate autopay, then I recommend doing your bills on the 1st and the 15th. So any bills due between the 1st and the 15th would be paid on the 1st. Bills due between the 16th to the 31st would be paid on the 15th. That way you only have to touch it twice. However, I highly recommend autopay to get the full automation. The third checking account is going to be your spending account. Not only will this have your fun spending money or family money, this will also have things like groceries, gas for your car, and these are items that fluctuate and can be borrowed from one another since you will not be borrowing from any other account. Again, when you're looking at spending money, including groceries and gas, this is the only account you want to look at. I cannot stress this enough. Don't get low on this account and peek into the irregular bill account and think, wow, there's extra money in there or in your savings account. That money has already been allocated. The reason this type of set it and forget it budget works is because oftentimes people who don't budget just look in their account and get a feeling for how much money is left to be spent. In some ways, this is the case here, but in this case, you would only look at this account. This ensures that all your bills are paid and that there's enough money to cover everything, including your irregular budget items. If you prefer to use credit cards, then I would try and have one spending credit card that is paid out of this account and maybe a bills credit card that is paid from the other account. This will just make it much easier to track the spending portion to make sure you're not going over the amount in the spending account and just make the review so much easier. The fourth account is going to be a high interest savings account. I would also recommend opening up this account at another bank that is not connected with the three other accounts because it makes it harder to take money from yourself. This account will have a progressive purpose. As you progress, you can open a couple of other high interest savings accounts, or you can just track it all in this account. The first thing you'll need to use this account for is to build up your emergency fund. If you have debt, then I recommend $500 for the first person in the household and an extra $100 for each person in the household. For example, a family of four would be $800. So goal number one is fill up this emergency fund. Once it's full, you can move that to a separate account, or when you're moving to the next step, just know that that, for example, $800 would not be included in the next step. The next step is going to be snowballing your debt. So you will pay the minimum on all your debts and take the smallest one and put all the extra money you have diverted into this account, not including the $800 of an emergency fund, to paying off the smallest debt. Continue that process until all of your debt is paid off. The next step will be growing your emergency fund from 3 to 6 months of expenses. Once that's complete, I would start investing as much of this money as you can. As an easy way to do that, investing in index funds through mutual funds or ETFs. If you want to have it completely automated, the mutual funds are the easiest because you can have them set up to have an automatic withdrawal to be invested each month. The last way you can use this account or get another savings account is to use it as a milestone savings. This would be like saving for a new car, a wedding, a new TV, a vacation. Basically, this final account is your emergency fund, saving, and investing account. I'm about to share with you my bonus tip on how to really automate your budget. Before I do, I would just like to quickly explain how the maintenance of the budget works. The only maintenance would be each month glancing at the balances to make sure they are sufficient, glancing at the items to make sure there are not any errors or overcharges. Then basically go through this exercise once a year to reset the amounts and just check in with where you are. This is the time where if you have any extra money above your cushion and your first two accounts, that you can take that money out and invest it or spend it. I would not take any money out of those accounts except at the end of the year, and you can consider it a bonus for doing the work yearly and coming in under budget. Now, if you get on this path and you find that personal finance is not overwhelming or unpleasant, then you could of course spend more time on it monthly as you wish, looking at the money you saved, working on ways to be able to save and invest more and spend less. Honestly, as people start crushing their debt, building up a savings, investing, watching their passive income grow, suddenly personal finances don't feel like a chore anymore. And it can actually be very exciting. Watching your passive income grow is like getting your regular pay raise without having to do more work, take on more duties. The important part is taking the first step to mastering your finances. And that's just knowing where your money's going, even if that is with a super simple set it and forget it budget like this one. It does not get simpler than this. Don't forget to grab the quick cheat sheet below. It lays out all this and gives you the categories, a quick workbook to set it all up. Now, the best way to fully automate this is out of sight and out of mind. And there's a couple ways to do this, and it depends on your employment. One, if you're employed with a company, then once you decide how much will go into each account, have them direct deposit that amount into each account. Historically, your check would only be deposited into one account. However, it is becoming more and more common that your paycheck can be divided amongst multiple accounts. That way you never see it or have to touch it, and the money just goes in and it is less tempting. Literally, you set it up once and then it just works on its own. Like I said, out of sight, out of mind. The only time you need to tweak this is if a bill dramatically changes or if you got a pay increase. You would just need to change the allocation for that account. Now, number two, if you're self-employed or your company says they don't allow multiple accounts, then I recommend setting up automatic monthly payment transfers within your account so you don't have to manually move the money. Again, that is more automated and less tempting. Thank you so much for watching, and don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.